स्थापकाय च धर्मस्य सर्वधर्मस्वरूपिणे अवतार वरिष्ठाय रामकृष्णाय ते नमः। नमस्कार टू ऑल ऑफ यू, वेलकम टू द स्टडी ऑफ लाइफ ऑफ द हाउस होल्डर डिसाइपल्स ऑफ श्री रामकृष्ण। वी वर लुकिंग इनटू द लाइफ ऑफ गिरीश चंद्र घोष। वी विल कंटिन्यू फ्रॉम वेयर वी हैड left yesterday. Girish Chandra Ghosh, when Sri Ramakrishna fell sick and he would be bedridden, he did not visit master very often. Girish did not visit master very often at Kashipur because he could not bear to see Sri Ramakrishna ill. One day, Girish Chandra Ghosh went there to Kashipur after the master had eaten some farina pudding, that is payasam. The unwashed cup with the remnant of the pudding mixed with the discharge from his throat wound was still on the floor, and some tiny ants were eating it. Pointing to the cup, Sri Ramakrishna said to Girish, "Look, look, Girish, in spite of this, still people call me an avatar." Girish immediately remarked, "Sir, now even those ants will get liberation. For what other reason should you have this disease?" So such was the faith of Girish in Ramakrishna. You can see even at this last moment, Sri Ramakrishna is increasing the faith or showing us what amount of faith Girish Chandra Ghosh had. Whatever might be the external condition, whatever might be the external circumstances, faith of Girish Chandra Ghosh was constant, achala. It would not be disturbed at all. Sri Ramakrishna gave up his body in Mahasamadhi on August 16, 1886. A devotee brought the sad news to Girish, but Girish Chandra Ghosh would not believe it at all. He said to the man who brought this news, "This is a lie. The master cannot die. Sir, I have come from that place. You had better go back there. But I have seen him with my own eyes." Girish covered his eyes with his hands and retorted, "You say whatever you want. I have not seen with my eyes, so I do not believe that Ramakrishna is possible." Girish later said, "I heard of Sri Ramakrishna's passing away, but I did not go to Kashipur to see him. I knew it would be very hard for my weak mind to maintain faith in Sri Ramakrishna's immortal nature if I were to see his dead body. Moreover, my eyes would stand against my faith, and it would tell me Sri Ramakrishna is dead. Did you not see it with your own eyes? For this reason, I intentionally kept a conflict between my eyes and my ears about the master's passing away. If my ears tell me Sri Ramakrishna is dead, I shall tell them, 'You have heard so many rumors about master. Are you going to believe everything you hear? Let people say whatever they want. I did not witness the master's death, so I do not believe in it.'" Girish had the firm conviction that master was God himself, and that his body was eternal and full of pure consciousness. disease or death could not touch his body. Because he was born as a human being, he acted as a human being, and death was also a part of his acting. Soon after Sri Ramakrishna's passing away, misfortune again hovered over Girish. He lost his two daughters. His second wife died in 1887, and a few years later, a young son who had been very much devoted to Holy Mother Sharda Devi also passed away. In the words of one of his dramas, Girish summed up his feelings: "Life is very painful. The world is empty. A beautiful flower garden has withered away." Now, this roused a blazing fire of renunciation. A blazing fire of renunciation was growing in Girish Chandra Ghosh's mind, burning up all his attachments, burning up all his desires and impurities. Now, you can remember the saying of Sri Ramakrishna. What is that? Do you remember? The garlic cup was being heated and the garlic odor was disappearing. One day, one of the direct disciples, Swami Niranjanananda, a monastic disciple of Sri Ramakrishna, said to Girish, "Girish, the master made you a monk, a sannyasin. There is no need for you to stay at home." Girish Chandra Ghosh took the advice of his brother disciple as an order from the master. He left home barefooted, wearing only a single cloth, and went to Baranagar Monastery. However, the other monastic disciples sent him back home again because they knew that Girish Chandra Ghosh's body would not be able to bear the austerities, the difficulties, the hardship of a monk's life. Girish Chandra Ghosh then went to visit Holy Mother in Jairambati. Holy Mother Sharda Devi was living in Jairambati at that time, her village home. Girish liked the spiritual atmosphere of Jairambati, and also he visited Kamarpukur, the birthplace of Sri Ramakrishna. The charming beauty of the meadows, the quiet evening sunsets over the open fields, the touching simplicity of the villagers, and especially the affection and grace of Holy Mother Sharda Devi, all conspired to console Girish's bereaved heart. Girish asked Sharda Devi permission to embrace the monastic life, but Holy Mother Sharda Devi persuaded him to remain a householder, devoting himself to writing plays depicting Sri Ramakrishna's life and teachings. After some time, Girish Chandra Ghosh returned to Calcutta with new hope and inspiration. Now, Sri Sharda Devi became the light of his life now again. She started guiding Girish Chandra Ghosh. So she used to always tell the householder disciples, for them too, they can take up sannyasa, but it should be internal. Householders need not take external sannyasa, but they can maintain the internal sannyasa, the internal detachment, the internal longing for God. So householders need not take external sannyasa. That was her advice to the householders. Now, she also advised Girishchandra Ghosh not to give up his house or not to go to the monastery. But she told her the better thing was he should devote himself to writing dramas concerned with gods and goddesses, spirituality, and especially, mother told, to write plays depicting Sri Ramakrishna's life and also his teachings, because this is a talent that everybody will not have. Everybody cannot write dramas, poetry, and other imaginative things. So they should have that talent. So the talent doesn't come out by practice, it is inborn. So Girish had this wonderful talent, and so turn it towards God, and whatever talent you had will now purify you. So that was what Sri Sharda Devi is telling Girishchandra Ghosh. Continue writing dramas, poetry, life of great souls, saints, and especially she told to writing plays depicting Sri Ramakrishna's life and as well as teaching. After some time, Girishchandra Ghosh now returned back to Calcutta from Jairambati and Kamarpukur with new hope and inspiration. Later, when Sharda Devi was staying in Calcutta, Sharda Devi also went to the theatre to see Girishchandra Ghosh dramas and acting a few times, and she enjoyed it immensely. Girishchandra Ghosh's hedonistic spirit had been subdued now by the spiritual touch of Sri Ramakrishna. Now Girishchandra Ghosh's lifestyle was changed. Now can you imagine such a drunkard? He gave up drinking the last 20 years of his life, and yet his previous lifestyle no doubt contributed greatly to his success as an actor and dramatist. The intensity with which his gigantic heart had felt the grief, so much of hardship, deaths he had to see in the end of his life. So all that grief, the despair, and now the hope and joy by the guidance of Sharda Devi made it possible for Girish to portray the character of his dramas vividly. You should note that the difficulties and the problems faced by these drama writers, the playwriters, the poets, that gives them the full experience of life, whereby it brings out the best out of them. The creation they do now in the form of new dramas will have that variety and depth that you could see now in the playwrights of Girish. The intensity with which the gigantic heart had felt grief, joy, despair, and hopes, this made it possible for Girishchandra Ghosh to portray the characters of his dramas very vividly. Girish himself used to say that the poet and the playwright could imbue their writings with life and feelings only if they had had first-hand experience of all the facets of life themselves. He once said, "Who can criticize the portrayal of characters in my plays? I have studied the lives of all types of people, from the prostitute to the Paramahamsa, illumined soul. See the experience and see the statement." What a wonderful statement. We have to go through that again. Who can criticize the portrayal of characters in my plays? And what a wonderful statement now he's going to make. I have studied the lives of all types of people, from the prostitute to the Paramahamsa, illumined soul. His power of imagination was so strong that he could actually visualize the character of his dramas. Once he asked Swami Sharadanandaji Maharaj to visit him every day so that he could talk with him about Sri Ramakrishna. He said, "I need a little diversion. I am now writing a drama on Mir Qasim." Who was that Mir Qasim? A Muslim ruler of Bengal who was betrayed by his own people. "Oh, what a conspiracy. I cannot bear it anymore. I see Mir Qasim even in my dreams. His bearded face moves before my eyes. There have been many books and articles written about Sri Ramakrishna's influence on Girish Chandra Ghosh's plays. Girish himself acknowledged the fact. When I wrote the play Vilva Mangala, several of his, that is Sri Ramakrishna's, devotees questioned me about it. I told them I had learned the art of playwriting from Sri Ramakrishna. Swami Vivekananda read Girish Vilva Mangala many times and said that each time he got a new light from it." Who told this? Swami Vivekananda himself, after reading the play written by Girish Chandra Ghosh on Vilva Mangala, Swami Vivekananda read Girish Vilva Mangala many times and said that each time he got new light from it. Such was the impact of the deep influence of Sri Ramakrishna and also the depth of his imagination in filling up the characters. In one of the dramas, that is Rupa Sanatana, now, Girish Chandra Ghosh portrayed Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu touching the feet of the devotee in salutation. This created a furore which shocked some of the followers of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and they challenged Girish on its authenticity. To which Girish Chandra Ghosh replied, "I saw with my own eyes that Sri Ramakrishna touched the feet of his devotees. I do not write about anything I have not experienced. Once there was a religious meeting with devotional singing in the house of the devotee." Let us go back a little and understand what is meant by that statement of Girish Chandra Ghosh. First of all, in his drama Rupa Sanatana, Girish portrayed that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is touching the feet of his devotees in salutation. when it was challenged by the followers, fanatic followers of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu about its authenticity, what was the reply of Girish Chandra Ghosh? I saw with my own eyes that Sri Ramakrishna touched the feet of his devotees. You know that Ramakrishna used to take the dust of the feet wherever the devotees would sing or wherever the devotees would stand and do the sankirtan or sit at one place and do satsang. Ramakrishna would go after the devotees had left. He would take the dust of the feet and put it on his head. When some of the devotees objected, he told, wherever devotees gather together and sing the name and glories of that particular god or goddess, the Lord will come assemble at that place to hear how the devotees sing his glories. You should note that there is a statement in Bhagavata, Naham Vasami Vaikunte Yogi Nam Hrudayena Cha. And Narada asked, where do you live, O Lord? To which Narayana Vishnu replied, I don't live in Vaikuntha, or I don't live in the heart of the yogis. Then where do you live, O Lord? Yatra yatra bhaktaha gayanti tatra tishtami Narada. Wherever my devotees sing my glories, there I manifest, O Narada. That is the statement of Lord Vishnu or Narayana in Bhagavatam. So exactly like that, Ramakrishna knew it. He could see the manifestation of the Lord wherever the devotees would gather. Just like we, the devotees gather together and do satsanga. We sing the glories. We do bhajans, we do aratis, we read about God. So whenever such things happen, when large group of people gather and think of God, there is a statement of Bhagavata, and Ramakrishna also had noticed it. He had felt the presence of God. So now you have come to know something special in your life. What is that? Whenever and wherever you people gather, the devotees of the Lord, and with devotion do his service, sing the glories, do his arati, satsanga, then the deity manifests there. It is true. It is a statement in Bhagavata, and also Ramakrishna has told about it. So Ramakrishna himself would go and take the foot dust of the devotees where they had sung bhajans. When asked, used to tell, the Lord has manifested in that place. Wherever the devotees gather together in satsang or sing his glories, the Lord manifests them. So Girish Chandra Ghosh had seen Ramakrishna taking the dust of the devotees' feet. Now we learned so many things from that, and also it gave a proof to the statement of Bhagavatam. The Lord manifests in the place where the devotees gather together and sing. So have faith. Remember, always when you are now sitting in satsang or in the arati or wherever you gather, or even you alone, the moment you start singing his glory, especially if there are more people in satsang, then the Lord will definitely manifest. So be sure about it, because Ramakrishna himself has told about it. So now Girish had so much faith in the words of Sri Ramakrishna. He depicted in his character as if Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is touching the feet of his devotees in salutation. So Girish replied, I saw with my own eyes that Sri Ramakrishna touched the feet of the devotees. And then he also makes comment that I do not write about anything in my playwright which I have not experienced myself. Once there was a religious meeting and devotional singing in the house of a devotee, and Sri Ramakrishna took the dust of that place and smeared it on his body. when the devotees tried to stop him, he said, look, don't you know this place has been sanctified by the presence of the devotees? By spiritual talks and devotional singing, God comes to listen where his devotees glorify his name. See the words of Ramakrishna himself. I'll read it again so that you will remember it. It goes deep into your psyche and it will help you whenever you are in distress, whenever you are in doubt. You can remember these words of Ramakrishna and it will give you new faith, new light. What is that? Once there was a religious meeting with devotional singing in the house of a devotee, and Sri Ramakrishna took the dust of that place and smeared it on his body. When the devotees tried to stop him, saying that it is we have to take the dust of your feet and put it on our body or on the head. On the opposite way, you are taking the dust of the devotees' feet and putting on your body. That will be wrong for us to allow it to be done. Then what did Ramakrishna reply when the devotees tried to stop him doing so? Ramakrishna replied, look, don't you know this place has been sanctified by the presence of devotees? So wherever the devotees gather together, the presence of the devotees itself sanctifies the place. How? What is another statement of Bhagavatam? Tirthi kurvanti tirthani sa antarena gadabhruta. Wherever the devotees go, they carry in their heart the Lord in their heart. So wherever they go, wherever the devotees go, that place will become like a pilgrimage site, or it will be sanctified. So Ramakrishna is reiterating it. He is telling, look, don't you know this place has been sanctified by the presence of the devotees? So now, whoever it might be, whatever is might be his character, if he is a devotee of the Lord, then know for certain, I have many times quoted the Bhagavad Gita shloka. What is that verse of the Bhagavad Gita? Apichet sudaracharu bhajate mam ananyava sadureva samantavyam samyak vyavasito hi saha. Even if that person is the worst of the sinners and now he has taken up repeating the name of the Lord and his devotion to God is increased, which is sudaracharo bhajate, he started worshipping me ananyava with single pointed devotion, one minded intense devotion. Bhajate mam ananya bhak sadureva samantavyam. You should consider him as a saint now itself. Even though he has not become a saint, now itself you start considering him to be a saint. Why? How? Because in few more days, because he is worshipping me, he will become a saint. He will get transformed. So Ramakrishna is telling, look, don't you know this place has been sanctified by the presence of devotees, by spiritual talks. So wherever there is spiritual talks, that place, that mind, the body will be sanctified. So spiritual talks, spiritual lectures are not a waste of time. You would have that intense faith in the words of Sri Ramakrishna. What has Ramakrishna told? Look, don't you know this place has been sanctified by the presence of devotees, by spiritual talks and devotional singing? Even the place where devotional singing takes place becomes purified. Now, what is the next word, sentence which Ramakrishna tells? God comes to listen. God comes to listen where his devotees glorify his name. Nama guna kirtana. wherever the devotee is glorifying his name, the Lord will come there to listen. So be sure of it. When you are singing the bhajan, when you are hearing the talk of the Lord, even now, you are hearing, all of you are hearing the talk. And I am telling, and now Ramakrishna is manifested here in this place. In your mind, in your heart, and he has purified your place. Because these are the words of Ramakrishna himself. God comes to listen where his devotees glorify his name. God comes to listen where his devotees glorify his names. Now, one more special statement by Sri Ramakrishna. The very dust of this place has become pure by the footprints of the devotees. The very dust of this place has become pure by the footprints of the devotees. What a wonderful thing we have learnt. So much of joy we get by these statements. Now let us go forward studying the life of Girish. Girish's writing career began when he was 35 years, and it continued for 30 years. So he started writing these playwrights, dramas, poetry when he was at the age of 35. And how many years did he do it? 30 years. Now, what were his special qualities? He was a prodigious writer. Prodigy. He was a prodigious writer and produced during that time 79 works. Can you imagine? In that 30 years, he produced 79 works, including dramas, satires, and musicals. In addition, he wrote many short stories, articles, poems, and songs. His drama dealt primarily with religious, social, historical, mythological, and patriotic subjects. His innovative spirit had a lasting effect on the theatre in Bengal. In fact, Girish Chandra Ghosh, he became known as the father of the Bengal theatre. You should note that. Girish Chandra Ghosh became known as the father of the Bengali theatre. Girish has a special trait in him while writing the dramas. He avoided the traditional flowery language of the theatre because of its heaviness and artificiality. And so he introduced irregular blank verse in the conversation of his dramas. This eventually became a new style, and it eventually became known as Gairisha Chanda, you know, meters, Chanda, a new thing. So that was called by the name of Girish Chandra Ghosh, Gairisha Chanda. That is Girish meter. The language of his play is natural, forceful, colloquial, and poetic. He felt that action and interaction create the life force of the drama, and the spirit of the drama is carried along in its language. Girish Chandra Ghosh's mind, it was working so fast and prodigiously. You know that he's very intelligent. You have heard Brahmanandaji telling that in his lifetime he had seen two very, very intelligent people. That was, one was Girishchandra Ghosh and Swami Vivekananda, other one. But they were no match for Ramakrishna. That was the statement of Brahmananda ji. Now, Girish's mind worked so fast and prodigiously that he required secretaries, many secretaries, to take down his words. He could not write them fast enough himself. Absorbed in the flow of ideas, he would pace back and forth in his room and dictate all the dialects of the drama, He would pace back and forth in his room and dictate all the dialogues of the drama in a loud voice, as if he was acting each role himself. His secretaries always kept 3 pencils ready at hand. He could not use a pen and ink pot. At that time, there was no continuously filled up pen. They have to dip it in the ink and then write. The type of pen was different. So the secretaries would not use the pen and ink pot because there was never enough time to dip the pen into the pot. Once the secretary could not keep up with the speed of the dictation, and so he requested Girish to repeat what he had just said. Girish became angry and asked him not to break his mood. He told the secretary to put dots where he had missed words, and he would fill them up later. There are many stories about his writing talent. It is said that he would write one drama in a couple of days. Sitar Vanavas, the banishment of Sita, was written in one night. He also wrote 26 songs for Sadavar Ekadashi. In just one night, he composed 26 songs. Sister Devamata mentioned in Days in an Indian Monastery, one of the greatest, a 6-act drama entitled Vilva Mangala, the saint, was written in 28 hours of uninterrupted labor. Swami Subodhananda, one of the direct disciples of Sri Ramakrishna, said, "We have seen Girishchandra Ghosh dictating 3 different dramas to 3 different secretaries, one after another. On another occasion, Girishchandra Ghosh dramatized Kapala Kundala, a famous fictional work by Bankim Chandra Chatterjee, in one night, by dictating it to 4 secretaries. Girish was his own greatest competitor. That means nobody else could compete with him. Anupama, you cannot compare anybody with him. So that's why Girish himself was his own greatest competitor. Now you should note another similar statement of Swami Vivekananda himself about himself. Only another Vivekananda can understand what this Vivekananda has given to the world, or the work which Vivekananda has done. Only another Vivekananda can understand what Vivekananda has done in that short lifespan. Likewise, here they are telling that Girishchandra Ghosh was his own greatest competitor. That means nobody could compete with him. When one of his dramas was particularly well received, he felt that he had to work harder on the next, not separate, so tried to fit everything. So when one of his drama was particularly well received. He didn't feel happy and keep quiet, but that made him more responsible. He felt that he had to work hard on the next in order to surpass the previous one. He was fond of, see, it's a very funny thing, he was fond of defeating himself. This is what we have to learn, especially the students. He was fond of defeating himself. Sometimes the monastic disciples of Sri Ramakrishna, in order to bring a response out of Girish, would tease him and used to play prank with him. You are writing and acting prompted by your own desires, and yet you say that the master gave you the task of saving the fallen people of the world. Don't you feel ashamed to talk like that? So when the direct disciples, other sannyas and monks, would tease him in this fashion, Girish would boldly reply, "Wait, wait, brother. When I meet Sri Ramakrishna again, I shall tell him that I won't act the role of a villain anymore. The next time, let his monastic disciples play the villains, and I shall act the part of a noble character." Truly, Girish believed that it was Sri Ramakrishna who rose in his divine drama. So, see that belief, as I've been telling you many times, this whole life is a drama of the Lord. In every role, it is He Himself, the Lord Himself playing. So if you come to know that, there will be no distress, there will be no pain at all. See, in a different way, Girish Chandra Ghosh is also having that faith. When the monastic disciples taunted him, this drama, as a villain, as a drunkard. So, I will tell Master, I won't act in the role of the villain anymore, and I will tell, suggest some of your names. You are playing the good part of monastic members, the heroes. So I will ask Ramakrishna to give that part of mine, the villain part, to you. That means to play the part of the villain is very, very difficult. So see the belief, the faith, you can see the faith in that. He really believes that Ramakrishna has ordained all these parts to be played. Wait, brother, when I meet Sri Ramakrishna again, I shall tell him that I won't act in the role of a villain anymore. The next time, let his monastic disciples play the villains, and I shall act the part of a noble character. Truly, this world is a drama. You come to know, even if you are a worst of the characters or a sinner, that sting will be gone. And you can be a changed person. All your pain will vanish. Because you are playing your role. And who is making you play? The Lord Himself. If you believe really in that, you have faith in that, then there will be no guilt conscience. You can be the happiest person. Truly, Girish believed that it was Master who brought these devotees to the world to act in different roles in his divine drama. In the early days of his career, Girish had very little money, and because of his reputation, it was difficult for him to find financial backing for his ventures. You know, if you are alcoholic, it can take your money very quickly. Very costly, isn't it? I was reading some of the articles. People complain about inflation, rise in the rise in the cost of the food, milk, and everything. They complain, they will bring down the government. But the cost of alcohol is constantly increasing. The cost of cigars, cigarette, and other things, the drugs, they are constantly increasing. Nobody complains about it. They will be happy, and with all the difficulties, they will go and take it and buy it. But when it comes to other things, oh, they are so concerned. They are so active. But when it comes to alcohol, whatever might be the cost, they will go and have it with whatever difficulty. So if you are a drunkard, all your money is gone. I had told one devotee, if you had saved the money which you have put into the alcohol, drinking alcohol and cigarette, I think you could have built 10 temples of Ramakrishna. That must have given up all those habits. So Girish Chandra Ghosh, because of these habits, though he was earning money, all that would be gone. You have to learn from these things. Give up those habits. Now, in the earlier days of Girish Chandra Ghosh, he had very little money, and because of his reputation as a drunkard and so many other things, it was difficult for him to find financial backings for his ventures. However, in 1869, he founded the Bagh Bazaar Amateur Theatre, and shortly thereafter, a rich man invited the theatre company to enact Sadhavar Ekadashi, a social drama, in his house on the occasion of the worship of Divine Mother Durga. His portrayal was so realistic, because naturally he was a drunkard, so his portrayal will be very natural. So in his drama, Girish played the role of the drunkard. His portrayal was so realistic that through this role he first made a name for himself in the theatre. This is not surprising when one learns that he said to the stage manager before the performance, "I cannot portray a drunkard. If I have to drink colored water from the bottle on the stage, I want genuine wine." The result was that even the writer of the drama was present, was overwhelmed by Girish's acting. He told Girish, "This role seems to have been written for you only, and without you, the play would not be a success." Girish soon moved to the Star Theatre and he became its manager. His brilliant and creative mind always found ways to overcome the inevitable managerial problems. There was not sufficient money to buy expensive costumes. So he wrote Chaitanya Leela, the drama on the life of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, which Sri Ramakrishna saw. Because it required only a few ochre ropes and rosaries as costumes. So there is no cost of the costume, more money. There was not sufficient money but to buy expensive costumes, so he wrote Chaitanya Leela, the drama on the life of Chaitanya, and that's how Ramakrishna got attracted and he came to watch that in his theatre. Girish was actually the moving force behind establishing of several theatres in Calcutta, including the Bagh Bazaar Amateur Theatre, the National Theatre, and the Star Theatre, the Emerald, and the Classic, and the Minerva Theatres. So he founded so many theatres. He was himself a superb and versatile actor. And wherever he performed, crowds would come to see him. If there was the name that Girish Chandra Ghosh should play the role, a lot of people would come to see him play the role, because he was famous for the acting too. Not only was a playwright, a poet, writing good dramas, but he was also a very good actor. And wherever he performed, crowd would come to see him. See, surprisingly, so many talents. Now, one more great talent. Once he played 5 different roles in the same play. In the same play, can you imagine? Girish Chandra Ghosh, once he played 5 different roles. Kapal Kundala was that play, and proved by his performance the importance of each of the 5 characters. He played all the 5 characters perfectly, and he proved by his performance the importance of each of the 5 characters. Now, Deva Mata, she writes in her Indian monastery, days in an Indian monastery, she wrote, "I enjoyed meeting the noted Bengali dramatist Girish Chandra Ghosh, a gifted actor also. He is called the Garrick of the Bengali stage, as well as the Shakespeare of Bengali drama." So, Deva Mata, the Western disciple of Ramakrishna, she was well versed in the literature of the West. So she is praising Girish Chandra Ghosh and comparing him with the Western dramatist. She is writing, "I enjoyed meeting the noted Bengali dramatist Girish Chandra Ghosh, a gifted actor also. He is called the Garrick of Bengali stage, as well as the Shakespeare of Bengali drama. The measure of his gift as an actor is given in this incident." It's really interesting. This particular incident proved what a great actor he was, and also how he had become now egoless. What was that? "The measure of his gift as an actor is given in this incident." Vidyasagar, the scholar, Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar, was a scholar, the philanthropist, was once attending the drama of Girish Chandra Ghosh, Babu's theater, one night, when the actor was depicting a profligate in a scene where he was abusing a woman. So that act was so nicely depicted here, Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar became so absorbed and stirred by the vividness of the portrayal of that character, he lost his control. See, he was a great scholar, he was known for his good nature as a philanthropist, would be always composed. Such a man fell into that emotional trap and he lost his control when he saw Girish Chandra Ghosh depicting a profligate scene where he was abusing a woman. Vidyasagar lost his control, became so stirred up by the vividness of the portrayal. Can you imagine? In the theater, he took off his slippers, Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar, and threw it at the actor. And the slippers struck him and rebounded on the stage. Now, that actor was none other than Girish Babu. It hit his head or face and it fell back, rebounded on the stage. Girish Babu picked it up, placed that slipper on his head, and with a bow to the audience, he declared he had never received a more gratifying tribute or a reward. Slipper has hit him on the head of the face. And now see the reaction of Girish Chandra Ghosh. By coming into touch such an egoistic person, such a debauched, such a sinful, such a proud person, now by the touch of Ramakrishna, is transformed to such an extent that even when he was hit by a slipper, what was his reaction? Girish Babu picked up that slipper with great care. He placed on his own head, and with a bow to the audience, he declared that he had never in his life received such a more gratifying tribute. That was the real reward from him, for him, award for him. As would be expected, Girish Chandra Ghosh innovations in the theatre were met with some oppositions also. His regular blank verses was criticized by traditional writers. He was also vehemently attacked by Puritans for engaging prostitutes to play woman's role in his dramas. Before that, you know, the society of that time was different. Before that, men had enacted women's role. Often these women proved to be dedicated and talented actresses. They were poorly educated, but Girish trained them and wrote his dramas in simple language so that they could portray the character with naturalness. The famous star Tinkari said, "I was an unlettered girl. It was Girish Chandra Ghosh's grace that I am now an actress." Girish had a great feeling for art. He knew that the artistic faculty does not manifest itself properly if there was fear, uncertainty, pressure, or exploitation. Girish later donated 16,000 rupees to the authorities of the New Star Theatre to complete its construction and said to them, "Please do not humiliate or exploit the actors and actresses. Let them act freely." So he donated 16,000 rupees in those days. In the 1800s, donating 16,000 rupees, very huge amount. In what form? He told, "Please do not humiliate or exploit the actors or actresses. Let them act freely." Contrary to his reputation, Girish Chandra Ghosh was actually very serious-minded and steady. And because of this, he was able to overcome obstacles and criticisms and eventually gain the respect and attention of the public. In fact, Girish Chandra Ghosh's waywardness has been somewhat overemphasized by some. Dhan Gopal Mukherjee revealed another side of Girish Chandra Ghosh, the face of silence. Not only Girish was our greatest modern playwright, writes Dhan Gopal Mukherjee, he was also a great actor and producer. It was he who revealed to the woman of the underworld that they would change their lives for the better by taking up acting as a trade. So the prostitutes would have been prostitutes and would not come out of that. It was because of Girish they came to know that they had this talent of acting, and by that they could come out of the rut. So Dhan Gopal Mukherjee writes, it was he who revealed to the woman of the underworld that they could change their lives for the better by taking up acting as a trade. Many wretched souls he saved by training them to act. Not only that, he also lifted up and revealed to the eyes of the public at least half a dozen actresses of the highest rank who had hitherto been condemned to a life of vice, while boys played the parts of women on the stage. Since Girish, all that has been changed. This was the great tribute given by Dhanagopal Mukherjee, which shows the other side of Girish. The other day in India, when one of the star actresses, now an old woman, called on my wife and myself, that is Dhanagopal Mukherjee's writing, that actress called on my wife and myself, she told us how father, that is what she called Girish, those prostitutes, those women, fallen women, who later on became actresses and could come out of that prostitution, they used to call Girish as father. So now, this one of the women, now she was old. The other day in India, when one of his star actresses, now an old woman, called on my wife and myself, she told us how father, that is Girish Chandra Ghosh, that is what she called Girish, worked. He brought about a revolution in the life of womanhood in general. Women in terrible penury, instead of being forced down into the abyss of vice, were now rescued by the stage. But father, that is Girish Chandra Ghosh, he did not stop there. He brought us all in touch with the teachings of Sri Ramakrishna. He wanted us to come to the monastery during the hours of worship and pray to God. Some of us were afraid lest we soil the sacred grounds. But Father Girish Chandra Ghosh answered, if Ramakrishna were living, he would teach you and me himself personally. He loves us. Ramakrishna is the savior of the fallen. Ramakrishna loves all of us. Didn't he come to earth for the fallen people like ourselves? See, this is a very, very important point which we have to note. He not only saved them, gave them the roles and taught them acting and saved them from that wrongful life, but at the same time, that woman is telling, Girish brought us all in touch with the teachings of Sri Ramakrishna and purified our life. See the wonderful role played by Girish Chandra Ghosh. And then that woman is telling, Girish wanted us to come to the monastery during the hours of worship and pray to God, but we were afraid because of our wrong life earlier. We thought that if you go to the monastery, that place would be soiled. We would be defiling that place with our sinful life. Some of us were afraid lest we soil the sacred grounds. But Girish Chandra Ghosh answered, if Ramakrishna were living, see now he knew the karuna, the grace, the kindness of Lord Ramakrishna. So he would boldly answer, if Ramakrishna were living, he would be teaching you and me himself personally. Ramakrishna loves all of us. Didn't Ramakrishna come to earth for the fallen people like ourselves? See, that was the faith of Girish Chandra Ghosh. He not only got benefited, he bought many, many people. who were all fallen, who were all sinful, leading a sinful life, into touch with the teachings of Ramakrishna and life of Ramakrishna, and he transformed their life. That's why they are addressing him as Father. And see what that wonderful faith in Ramakrishna is. He loves us. Ramakrishna loves us. Didn't Ramakrishna come to earth for the fallen people like ourselves? What faith, what belief. We have to take that. Whatever we have committed, we need not bother. Ramakrishna has come for us. He loves all of us. Ramakrishna would be loving all the fallen people. We are not fallen to such an extent. Then how much he would be near to us. Now continuing, our talks with many other old actors and actresses convinced us. So those, that great man, Dhanagopal Mukherjee, is telling, our talks with many other old actors and actresses convinced that Girish, by staying with his old Bohemian companions, did more spiritual good than if he had left them. Now, did you know why Ramakrishna wanted that Girish should continue the same way, writing the playwrights, the dramas, the poetries, and the stage and the theatre? Not to come out of it, because so many people could be saved by that, by staying with his old Bohemian companions. Girish Chandra Ghosh did more spiritual good to go than if he had left them. After his soul's work, he repudiated nothing of his past. Instead, he slowly permeated his friends and his writings with the spirit of Sri Ramakrishna. Now, can you understand? The avatara is not only meant for the good. In olden days, the work of the avatara was to destroy the unrighteous. यदा यदा हि धर्मस्य ग्लानिर्भवति भारत अभ्युत्थानम् अधर्मस्य तदात्मानं सृजाम्यहं परित्राणाय साधूनां विनाशाय च दुष्कृतां. सो विनाशाय च दुष्कृतां, द बैड पीपल, द सिनर्स विल बी डिस्ट्रॉयड, सेज कृष्ण. बट नाउ द सेम कृष्ण हैज टेकन अप द रोल एज रामकृष्ण, where he will not be destroying. This time it is not with weapons, but it is transformation. Not vinashayacha duskratam, but parivartanaya duskratam. Transforming them. So now you can see how Ramakrishna showed his grace to Girish Chandra Ghosh, and through that his grace came on to all these fallen and wretched lives. Instead, now Girish Chandra Ghosh, instead of giving up the theatre, giving up these Bohemian companions, bad people, sinners, he slowly permeated their lives. And his writings with the spirit of Sri Ramakrishna. He would introduce everyone to life and teachings of Sri Ramakrishna. Take them to monasteries. And as for the power of attorney that he gave to his guru Sri Ramakrishna, Girish was the most religious of us all. He lives of the indwellers. So that power of attorney, you can understand now. And as for the power of attorney that he gave is to his guru, one of the monastic disciples, Swami Turiyananda, and others testify that Girish Chandra Ghosh never violated that power of attorney which he had given to Sri Ramakrishna. All of them, all of the other monastic disciples affirm Girish. See, they are telling, the monastic disciples, including Turiyananda, are telling. So you cannot just give it off. Girish was the most religious of us all. See, Turiyanandaji and others are comparing with themselves and telling Girish was the most religious of us all. He lived as he said he would. No hypocrisy, no compromises. He lived as he had. He lived as he had said he would live, by the promptings of the indwellers. So whatever his guru had told, whatever the God wants according to the will of the Lord, he would do that accordingly. It's really very, very soothing to hear that. What a marvel Ramakrishna did by this wonderful character called Girish. So many things he could do. Girish introduced among the performers a custom amongst the actors in the theater and other places. He introduced a custom which is practiced even today in Bengali theaters. Before making an appearance on the stage, every actor or actress goes down to the picture of Sri Ramakrishna. Thus, Sri Ramakrishna has become, in a sense, the patron saint of the Bengali theater, and his photograph can be found hanging backstage in the green room in the backstage in nearly every theater of Calcutta. So now you can understand the impact, the great impact of the life of Girish and the great impact of the life of Ramakrishna. See, we have been seeing so many characters. In all of the characters, Ramakrishna is playing a different role. But in this character called Girish Chandra Ghosh, what an impact on the society. And that is continuing even now in the theatres, amongst the actors and artists. Ramakrishna has been permanently introduced to them, whether on this stage, whether entering into the stage, in the green room, in the background, Ramakrishna was respected everywhere. Ramakrishna was introduced. And that changed the life of all these artists. What an impact. So the mind is full hearing all these things. Wonderful impact of Sri Ramakrishna, the avatara. The work of the avatara at all different levels, we cannot imagine. See, these are all the things which we have noticed in such uncertain places, unnoticed. What might be the impact Sri Ramakrishna has on all these venues, on all these stages, on all these different roles the avatara has to play this time? So it fills our heart to hear that. So we will stop this conversation with this wonderful high of our mind. It is really so feeling so much of happiness and joy. So we will continue the life of Girish Chandra Ghosh in the next class too. But only little is left. Then we will take up another householder disciple's life. But this is really marvelous and wonderful. I myself am feeling so full and blessed, because we could see another role of Sri Ramakrishna being played So let us enjoy this avatar's different role in this way. We'll meditate on Ramakrishna in this way. And also we will take up all that character within us and offer at the feet of Ramakrishna. We will also become one with Sri Ramakrishna, bringing up all these different characters lying hidden in our heart, in our subconscious mind, and divinize it, deify it, and offer it at the feet of Sri Ramakrishna. So we shall start today's conversation now with the prayer. Om Priyatam Pundarikakshah Sarvayakteshwaro Harihi Tasmin Tushte Jagat Tushtam Preedite Preeditam Jagat हरि ओम तत्सत् श्री राम कृष्णार्पणमस्तु थैंक यू नमस्ते ओम नमो नारायणाय.